All right, so now that you've read the PDF, right, we're going to be looking at a different method today, and that method is called the general method, right? So the measurements are there for the quadrilateral in the PDF, so we're going to use those measurements, right? AB is 70 mm. So we're going to draw AB first. Right, 70 mm. And BC is 50 mm. So I'm going to open to 50 on my compass. And I'm going to mark that off at point B, right? So, on this part here, you should know how to construct the quadrilateral, right? I shouldn't have to show you that, so I'm just going to skip forward to after I finish constructing the quadrilateral. Alright, so now that you have your quadrilateral constructed, the next step would be to extend this line here, which is AB. Alright? So, once you extend that line, you have to take note of the ratio, right? Remember, it's a reduction and the ratio is 3 to 5. So I'm going to open my compass to a small radius. And then from point B, right, I'm going to scribe 5 arcs. 5 arcs that are the same amount away, right? So 1. Two, three, four, and five. Right? So the reason why it's five is because the last number in the ratio is five, right? So you should have 5 arcs like this, same measurement away. Alright, that's the measurement that you open to on your compass. That's why I recommend that you use a small measurement, right? So now after that, alright, we're gonna bisect the distance from point A to point 5. Alright? So bisecting a line is something that you've done before and shouldn't be strange to you. You should know how to do it, right? Alright, so now that your line is bisected, right? This point here is going to be point E. Alright, so you take your compass, put it at where point E is, then you open to where point A is. And you're going to draw a semicircle. So that semicircle that you draw should go from A to where point 5 is. All right? So now we have to construct another semicircle, and this time we're going to bisect the distance from point A to where the number 3 is, right? So the reason why you're bisecting that distance to where the number 3 is because the first number in the ratio is 3, right? Remember, the ratio is 3 to 5. So we're bisecting this distance now. And that there is going to give you point F, right? So to construct the semicircle now, you go to where point F is, right? Open to A, and then you draw your semicircle. Alright, so that semicircle is going to go to where point 3 is. So now you have two semicircles, one going to where point 5 is and one going to where point 3 is, right? Since the two numbers in the ratio are 3 to 5. So for the next step, we're going to draw a perpendicular line from where point B is. And we're going to draw that line downwards. To pass through the two semicircles, right? And where it's touching the two semicircles, right? Where the fourth semicircle is, since it goes to point 3, we label that as 3-1, and the next one, which is going to point 5, we label that as 5-1. So now we're going to connect this point here, 5-1, to where point A is. Then you're going to take your set square, set it parallel to the line that you just draw, your ruler. Alright, so that's how it sets like. And you're going to slide it to where 0.31 is, and then you're going to draw your line. So that's going to be your line there, and that's going to give you a point here which we're going to label as G, right? So now, we're going to set the set square parallel to AD, alright? And we're going to slide that line to where point G is. Then, I'm going to draw in the diagonal from B to D. So where the diagonal touches this point here, that is going to be D1. So that's one side of the reduced figure already. Then set your set square parallel to CD. And slide it to where D1 is and draw a line. And that there is going to give you C1. Alright? And this is your reduced figure.